Welcome back. The disinvestment is back on the agenda again. It seems to be moving forward at rapid pace as promised by the government. Joining me now to discuss what some of the methodologies could be is former disinvestment secretary Pradeep Baijal. Mr. Baijal, thank you very much for joining us. So I think the question that I would put to you is, as we hear about NHPC and so on, is what are the two or three lessons from the methodology that we followed in your tenure in the past that we can now apply to ensure that this investment is a smoother process and does not encounter the opposition it began to encounter towards the latter days?
You see, there were two kinds of disinvestment, actually three kinds. The first was from 1990 to about 1991 to about 2000, when only minority disinvestment of shares was done, as the finance minister has announced now. Now, in that minority sale of shares, the recoveries were very poor. Then, from 2000 to about 2003, we did privatization, where the company became a private company. There, the recoveries were huge, and I have been quoting one number. In the old method, Maruti got 12 rupees. In the new method, we got, when we privatized, 120, same share, plus 1,000 crores, and a couple of days later, when the company is stabilized as a private sector company, we got 600 rupees. Mm. So, in privatization, the recoveries that you get are very poor, and there are many such examples, and I am not going into those examples.
You mean this disinvestment as compared to privatization?
That's right. Yeah. Now, when you come to disinvestment, basically, there are two kinds of disinvestment. One, like the government is saying for NHPC, that we will go for a public issue of shares. Now, public issue of shares, you don't sell government shares. You float new shares in the market. So, private holding comes in the equity, but not through sale of shares. Now, if the company requires money, then normally you go in for an IPO. Now, you know that NHPC has started many projects, and therefore, government has decided to go in for an IPO. Perhaps the government will get no money, and perhaps that is the reason why the government said we will only get 1200 crores this year from privatization, from disinvestment.
So, if we were to look at, so are you also saying that somewhere that we should either look at privatization because that will really get the kind of monies the government is looking for, or maybe not look at disinvestment in this manner, which is really piecemeal? Or
you see, you do disinvestment when you want to list the company in the market, because the company does not have a flavor of the market. So 10%, 15%, 20% in a company, go in for disinvestment so that the company gets listed, so that everyone has a ballpark number for the value of the company, and then you go in for privatization. But going in for disinvestment alone, you get so little money. And why are you doing disinvestment today? Because you are saying that there is a fiscal deficit. There is a huge fiscal deficit. Disinvestment is not going to plug even a part of that.
So, you are saying strategically weak path to follow.
That's right.
Okay. So, to come to privatization, I know this is not something that we can culminate in a minute, but of all the exercises that we did, I mean, right from, let's say, Modern Foods to Hotel Corporation, the Centaur Hotels, I mean, many of them sort of received considerable criticism, and some, of course, went through reasonably smoothly, including Balco. What's the sort of one or two key lessons that we can apply to the current context, if we were to go the privatization
route? You see, the government has to take a decision to go ahead for privatization. And I still maintain that whatever was the discussion on Centaur was totally, it was created. There was nothing in the Centaur case. You buy a house and tomorrow the value of that house doubles. Why 35%? You buy a government property and the moment you are able to run it, the value increases. Maruti, when you privatized, you got 120 rupees. When it became a private sector company, the value was 680 rupees. So, this 35% was an unnecessary propaganda. So, the only way of doing privatization is that you have methods which are totally transparent. And our methods were totally transparent. There was a joint secretaries committee, there was a secretaries committee, there was a ministers committee, and each decision was confirmed at each level. So, number of people were involved. But even in disinvestment, issues can come up. What is the price that you will fix for IPO? Will you fix a higher price or you fix a lower price. And today you look at the market, a company like GMR went to the market and could not complete its QIP. So you have to create a market condition where you can sell. Today you are not creating that market condition because the prices are going down.